Hey, what's up? CT here.
I'm Dean.
Joining us today in the studio is not Sasquatch, but this is his buddy Hunter, also a great squirrel that tends to hang around this place.
So where's Sasquatch?
He is out. He is actually on a trip. He is with part of the Rog family. More on that to come. Also, too, we'll be doing a giveaway towards the end of the show. This is actually a tool bag, got four pouches inside. Okay, so East just happened.
Just happened.
I just got back. How was it for you? What was it like?
So my Overland East experience was kind of limited because I was teaching 12 hours all weekend. So I didn't get to see a whole lot, but the classes went really, really well, very well received. Basically this year, I got to be in charge of or the lead instructor for an area called the Overland Essentials area. So we kind of took my 10 Essentials talk and kind of blew it into a full program area. And then Rodney from Overland Medic, we did a walk around of his Gladiator a while back. He's a professional fire medic and he came in, taught a first aid class. That was really, really good. But yeah, it was nice seeing a lot of familiar faces, but unfortunately, I only got to walk around the show field ever so briefly. I don't even think I made it to the prog booth. I felt bad, but.
I think for me, this was my favorite show so far. The venue was like perfect. Mm-hmm. Couldn't have been better.
Yeah.
Camping was as close as it could be. It was relatively flat everywhere, even in the camping area. Amenities were good and that kind of thing. And the weather was awesome. It was cool, overcast.
A little drizzly.
So yeah, it was a little drizzle on Saturday, I think, but that only lasted for like 2 hours. So,
A lot of people kind of poo-poo down their nose about, you know, when you're field camping. But my running joke has always been there's nothing overland about an overland festival anyway. We're all going to camp in the field together.
You're all just kind of festival camping anyway. But
for the size that Expo has grown to, this type of facility is almost necessary.
Do you know the final numbers? They were expecting about 15,000. And I would guess that they were close to that.
Yeah.
It was packed. It was tons of day pass people, just so much. And it was cool. Like, so many people came by. I got to meet a lot of you guys in person. Man, I can't remember. I don't remember all the names. Chicks Do It Too. So many other intense adventures.
The number of times that somebody yelled at me, "Hey, squirrel guy."
Like, really?
I have a name, okay? I have a name. But no, like, the number of times people like, "You're the squirrel guy from YouTube." And I'm like, wow, is that really what I'm known as? Like, my reputation is playing with stuffed squirrels on YouTube.
Expo is the place where, like, I'm suddenly a celebrity and get recognized. And anyway, that was awesome. Good to see you guys.
But you were busy filming walk-around videos.
Yeah, I think I shot 8 walk-arounds and then won a bonus video, so 9 videos. I was going wide open.
We were struggling last year because we didn't have any walk-around videos, so we had to, like, bribe people to come to the shop or get them at a few of the events we were at, but... You know, Expo, you know, there's so many cool vehicles and, you know, some unique stuff that I think when we start doing walk around videos going from, you know, into 2022, I think there's gonna be some really cool, very unique.
There were some really awesome vehicles. So looking forward to that.
Yeah.
As far as what is new coming down the pipe, we've been teasing this for a while, guys. Yeah. Now this, as you saw, This was a work in progress prototype. The finished product is there's a whole new line of stuff called Triple Run, and the name comes from moonshining the best, most distilled, strongest stuff. So this is our best and strongest stuff yet. Again, it uses the laser cut front with the dual tone color behind it. It also has the handles worked through it, woven through, so it's incorporated into the entire bag. And that gives you these vertical loops. We've got some stuff that's going to attach up to those. More on that kind of stuff later. Also on the back, it's got the 4 attachment points. You'll be able to hook stuff there. So we're working on videos. We're working on the products. We've got a bunch of stuff coming down the pipe. Here's what a GP pouch and the new style is going to look like. It's all going to match. It's going to be unified with the custom color seat back panels are going to be the Triple Run seat back panels. They're going to get a refresh as well. And it's all going to look really awesome together. But it's not just refreshes. There's new stuff coming too. including something you guys have been asking for since 2018 when we came up with a design for something and kind of teased it.
Mapfolios?
This was...
Everybody asks about those too, but no.
Not Mapfolios. So you guys hounded us so much, we had to take that build video down because it was like, you guys were, and we were like, well, we haven't got the design quite right. Well, now we've got the design right and it's ready for production. So a bunch of new stuff coming between now and the end of the year.
And then also there's another bag that we're not even going to tease yet right now. That is basically going to be the foundation of a multi-bag info system that is really, really cool. And I'm actually excited about it. I almost took one of the prototypes for myself because I'm like, ooh, I could use this.
If you were at East, you saw one of those. We brought 5. We sold them all. Sorry to the people who kept asking. We're like, nope, early bird gets the worm. Yep. And now a quick update on Sasquatch's adventures. Now, if you guys didn't know, our boy Sasquatch the Squirrel, he's trying to visit all 50 states in 2021. I think he's made it to 33 now.
Because I got him.
Then he traveled with our guy Dean here to Oklahoma when he was going out to what trip was that?
Well, that was the infamous Expo Mountain West to West back to East trip with a little flight in between.
Yes, okay. And then he went with @4GVN.adventure to the historic Bastow Village in New Jersey. And then he made sure not to miss Expo East with us, so he came out there. He went with @RavenS117. And then right now, he is with Team Veterans United, traveling the entire Rebel Rally 2021. They're on like day six, seven, yeah. Something it's like that. Now, it's got a few more days to go. You can follow along on that Team Veteran United's Instagram, or just go to the Rebel Rally Instagram and you'll see some photo updates of that. Really cool land navigation race happening out west. Now, he still needs your help to hit some of those northern states. Someone needs to go up to Maine and just hit New York City, all good stuff. T-minus 2 months, guys. He needs your help. All you got to do is get the t-shirt or the patch and take a picture of it and tag that with the location tag, post on Instagram. Don't forget to #GetSasquatchWasHere and we will find it.
All right, my favorite segment, event news. We are at the end of the year and there's not very many events going on. We had Expo East last weekend, but coming up we have the Virginia Rooftop Tent Rally, James River State Park. We, of course, will be there. Also going on this weekend is a rendezvous in the Ozarks. We really need to coordinate schedules so we don't interfere, but that's neither here nor there. Rendezvous in the Ozarks is a great event. Also coming up, we have the Woodland Adventure in Central PA. This is kind of a fun, laid-back rally event hosted by my buddy Kyle from Off-Road Consulting. That's up in kind of Central PA and kind of bounces around a few of the off-road parks up there. It's on November 7th. Also, we have Rigs and Coffee at Pep Boys in New Jersey. Been to that event a couple years ago. That'll be on November 6th. And of course, kind of rounding out the season is the Overland Flea Market, November 13th. We will have on-site camping for that. So bring your high-quality used Overland surplus to buy, sell, and trade. We'll be camping out Friday and Saturday night. That's going to be off-site. It's not going to be here at the shop, but we'll have plenty of room for people to camp. It'd be a good time.
So Dean, how do people win the So Sample one-of-one tool bag?
So in order to win this So Sample, since it's the end of the season, we want to hear your most memorable camping experience. If it was a shenanigan, if something crazy happened, the crazier the story, the better. But of course, please be honest. Don't just make stuff up. Let us know what happened. What was your favorite event? What was your favorite trip? Drop it down in the comments below. If you have photos, please feel free to DM us photos or tag us in an album or something like that. You can either work on Instagram or comment on YouTube, and you will win a chance you will have a chance to win this one of one prototype So Sample Blue Ridge Overland Gear laser cut tool bag. All right, CT, what do we have coming down the pipeline next?
I am glad you asked. So our boss Matt recently had his Suburban rebuilt for overlanding. Jeremy with Family Adventures Overlanding did the whole thing. He's an awesome mechanic and he did electrical, mods, bumper, you name it, lighting, a whole deal. And he documented the whole thing. So we're gonna start releasing those videos in a week or so.
That'll be fun.
Is that all the fun we have?
No.
Oh,
it is
okay.
Not all the fun we have.
Okay.
We,
we're does gonna this have to do with all the people that were snapping pictures of
no,
me?
No, no, this
at
does
East?
Not.
I think we should share that.
No,
that was pretty
this
good.
Has to do with what's in this bag. This super secret thing, James Blake.
I think he told me a little bit about this, but I didn't hear any more after
oh,
that.
Oh yeah, no, I told him to keep it under wraps. So a while back we did something on snacks and James Blake decided that he was gonna gift us a little something something. So he dropped off at Overland Expo East a bag of stuff that we can't get in the US.
Whoa.
So these are Kit Kats.
Wait, is this mango? Summer yeah. Mango Kit Kat?
All right.
Oh.
Matcha green tea, strawberry.
Okay. Oh. None of these are chocolate. I'm really worried.
Cookies and cream.
Okay, that's okay. Getting better.
I know.
Okay.
Ben, come here.
Yeah, what am I doing?
What? You're gonna taste some weird things. So I've got two volunteers here that have no idea what we're about ready to do, but we are going to taste Kit Kats from foreign countries.
Okay.
Strawberry?
Yes.
Oh, God.
Here's a great question. Which one do you not?
Here we go.
See, I'm not a strawberry fan either, but
I don't know. This weirds me out. It's like it should be chocolate, and it's just
like this.
It smells like real strawberry.
Right, but it
tastes like a breakfast bar.
Strawberries and cream. It's delicious.
It tastes like good strawberry ice cream. I'm a fan.
Yeah, not a strawberry fan, but I would give this one like a 7, maybe even an 8. No, I am a green tea drinker. I can't drink coffee. So I am actually excited about this one.
Apple maybe?
Mango. Mango.
Nope.
I just gotta go full bore.
No, I mean.
I'm not tasting much yet.
I'm actually disappointed in this. Yeah,
this one didn't like, taste like anything
no,
to us.
Like, yeah. So it's supposed to be matcha green tea.
That's probably why it don't taste like
yeah. Part of cream.
Still didn't like
I mean,
it.
Yeah, you get the cream flavor, but nothing.
Yeah.
All right. But we'll move on to another fun one.
All right.
That's actually pretty good.
I'm not feeling it.
You're not feeling it?
He couldn't do it. What do you think?
This is a no from
oh,
Ben.
Man. Oh, God. It's lotion.
It's lotion.
It's lotion, he says.
It's a lotion.
Now that he says that.
Dude, is that not lotion?
I feel like this is a trick.
I've had all four of them.
Except for mango, right?
No, the mango one wasn't bad.
If I like the mango one.
I will try the lotion one.
Yeah.
Starburst. Lotion.
This shit's wrong, man. Nah, that's like two thumbs down, bro.
All right, this one will make up for it. All right, this is the final one.
I like it, though. It's pretty good.
Cookies and cream.
It's pretty on point with the cookies and cream.
Yeah.
Play.
Yeah.
The mango's very bad. Don't get the mango.
Unless you really like mango.
Right, right.
Copper tone.
Thank you, James.
Thank you.
Anyone else who wants to send us snacks? Feel free, because obviously,
you know, address is on the website, 2687 Rocky Ford Road, Bedford, Virginia, you know.
Attention CTMD.